AI could be the most trending topic of the decade. It is everywhere we turn and advancing at unprecedented speeds. This has caused the subject to be debated, discussed, and analyzed at great lengths, and as this video is evidence, will likely continue to be, at least until it is prohibited by our robot overlords. Of course, I'm only, well, half joking. There are fears that AI has the potential to be a civilization-ending entity, where fictional household names such as the Terminator or iRobot inch closer to reality. However, as with every theory, there is always an opposing one. Many suggest that AI will, in fact, bring on the beginning of a utopian era, an era where leisure time is in abundance and suffering is at a minimum. It is even conceptualized that humans may one day augment themselves with AI, creating a powerful bond between organic and synthetic life. This may sound far-fetched, but we can see our species making leaps and bounds as we speak. So, how advanced is artificial intelligence in the 21st century? Well, self-driving cars are set to change the world in a massive way. Every automobile company is investing billions into the technology, and if they don't, they will get left behind. Startups are creating data management systems, radars, cameras, and other cool tech that can be offered to the highest bidder. And Google, of course, has its own self-driving car project, Waymo, which will most likely be sold to car companies, much like what they do with their Android operating system for mobile phone manufacturers. So, if Waymo is the Android of self-driving cars, then Tesla is most closely comparable to Apple. Tesla have developed all their own software and hardware and are currently leading the pack in the electric vehicle and autonomous driving industry. But more on Tesla and Musk in a second. And what else? Well, only a few years ago, it was predicted that it would take a decade or more before AI could beat top players at the millennia-old game Go. But in 2016, AlphaGo made headlines by beating Lee Sedol, ranked second in the world. From there, it went from beating the top Go player to being able to beat 50 top players simultaneously. What's more, just over a year later, the completely self-taught AI AlphaGo Zero was able to defeat AlphaGo with little difficulty. The creators of this AI say that this was an important advancement towards building artificial general intelligence systems, or AGIs. An AGI is an AI with intelligence closer to a human's lateral thinking, rather than an AI that is built for specific tasks, like playing games with defined and finite rules, such as chess. Wow, we could be looking at the golden age of AI, but that's just our opinion. What do the experts think the future will bring? 2017 saw two of the biggest tech titans in the world fundamentally disagree on the future of AI. Elon Musk, the visionary CEO of Tesla, SpaceX, Neuralink, and until recently OpenAI, and Mark Zuckerberg, creator and CEO of the social media juggernaut Facebook. Musk sits on the more pessimistic side of the AI fence with a general message that we should be absolutely terrified of AI. This may sound strange, seeing as Mr. Musk is a pioneer in AI advancement. However, just as Frankenstein grew to despise his creation, Musk may be seeing the potential flaws in playing God, too. Musk and his cross-industry teams have pushed AI into the realms of sci-fi-like territory. As we mentioned, self-driving cars are set to shake up the automobile industry in ways unseen since we said goodbye to the horse and carriage, and Tesla is at the forefront of this technology. And while Tesla's cars are not yet capable, or better, allowed of fully autonomous driverless transport, they are equipped with the hardware that will eventually allow them to drive without any human input. You won't even have to tell your car where to go most of the time, as it will gradually learn your schedule. Musk has even boasted that autonomous cars will be the safest mode of transport ever, having the ability to see and hear in all directions, which is way beyond the regular human capability. Well, self-driving airplanes will probably disagree. Something else worth mentioning is that in July 2018, Elon Musk launched the Falcon 9 rocket for the second time, as it had previously used AI to land itself back on Earth. Working so closely with AI and making countless technological breakthroughs makes Elon's stark warning about the ominous nature of AI all the more concerning. He acknowledges this himself.
I'm really quite close to, I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows. And the rate of improvement is exponential.
Musk has also warned his fellow AI pioneers that unless steps are taken to control the speed at which AI is being developed, along with putting regulations in place when developing thinking machines, dangerous things can happen.
I'm not normally an advocate of regulation and oversight. I mean, I think one should generally err on the side of minimizing those things. But this is a case where you have a very serious danger to the public. And therefore, there needs to be a public body that has insight and then oversight on to confirm that everyone is developing AI safely. This is extremely important. I think the danger of AI is much greater than the danger of nuclear warheads by a lot. And nobody would suggest that we allow anyone to just build nuclear warheads if they want. That would be insane. And mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes. Far. So why do we have no regulatory oversight? This is insane.
In fact, we can go as far as in our speculation as saying that artificially intelligent robots will inevitably become our malevolent rulers at best, and wipe us out completely at worst. According to Musk, the start of humanity's decline begins with the fact that robots will be able to do everything better than humans. And he means everything. Adding to this worrying sentiment, Musk believes that AI has the potential to start a third world war. In fact, it is all within an AI's capability to gain access to nuclear launch codes, deliver fake data to rival nations, and even replicate human speech, all of which could lead to disastrous results. And there is something else that's a worrying possibility. Especially if AI technology is not widely available, it can be weaponized without being fully understood.
The best of the available alternatives that I can come up with, and maybe somebody else can come up with a better approach or better outcome, is that we achieve democratization of AI technology, meaning that no one company or small set of individuals has control over advanced AI technology. I think that's very dangerous. It could also get stolen by somebody bad, you know, like some evil dictator of a country could send their intelligence agency to go steal it and gain control. It just becomes a very unstable situation, I think, if you've got any incredibly powerful AI. You just don't know who's going to control that.
So, it is not a stretch to think that AI will be the next scientific breakthrough that will be used to destroy. And once this Pandora's box is open, it won't be easy to close. You may be thinking, if Musk is so sure that AI could spell the end of civilization, why on earth would he continue to push it further and further? Well, it makes sense that if Musk is at the helm, then he can steer these advancements in the right direction and away from the iceberg which threatens to sink what could be our greatest technological achievement. And if he fails, he is obviously planning on moving humanity to Mars and leaving Earth to the robots. Ha! On the other side of the proverbial fence, you have Zuckerberg, who, upon hearing Musk's not-so-optimistic prophecies, vocally dismissed them, and even called them irresponsible.
You know, I have pretty strong opinions on this. I'm really optimistic, right? I'm an optimistic person in general. I think you can build things and the world gets better. But with AI especially, I'm really optimistic. And I think that people who are naysayers and kind of try to drum up these doomsday scenarios are I don't understand it. I think it's really negative, and in some ways I actually think it's pretty irresponsible, because you know, in the next 5 to 10 years, AI is going to deliver so many improvements in the quality of our lives. If you think about just safety and health and keeping people safe, you know, AI is already helping us basically diagnose diseases better, match up drugs with people depending on what they're sick, so that way they can get treated better. So it's going to help a whole lot of people get treated and get better health care than would have had access to it before. If you look at self-driving cars, they're going to be safer than people driving cars. You know, that's only a matter of time. And one of the top causes of death for people is car accidents still. And you know, if you could eliminate that with AI, that is going to be just a dramatic improvement in people's lives.
The CEO of Facebook is also understandably invested in online security, especially after the Cambridge Analytica shenanigans.
Well, Congressman, the issue with Cambridge Analytica and Alexander Kogan happened before we ramped those programs up dramatically. But one thing that I think is important to understand overall is just the sheer volume of content on Facebook makes it so that no amount of people that we can hire will be enough to review all of the content. We need to rely on and build sophisticated AI tools that can help us flag certain content. And we're getting good in certain areas. One of the areas that I mentioned earlier was terrorist content, for example, where we now have AI systems that can identify and take down 99% of the Al-Qaeda and ISIS-related content in our system before someone, a human, even flags it to us. I think we need to do more of that.
As Facebook and social media grow faster and bigger, more advanced AI becomes necessary to prevent misbehavior and various types of discrimination. AI systems that can recognize faces, spot spammers, remove fake accounts, and reduce digital fraud are already in place.
In the future, we're going to have tools that are going to be able to identify more types of bad content. And I think that there are moral and legal obligation questions that I think we'll have to wrestle with as a society about when we want to require companies to take action proactively on certain of those things.
Zuckerberg has made it clear that without AI, humans would not be able to handle digital security to an acceptable level. And even now, work is constantly being done to improve the AI's capabilities. Musk and Zuckerberg use social media, interviews, and public statements to disavow the other's opinion. And, as is often the case with many scientists and celebrities in an open disagreement with one another, we have to ask who is right. Well, in this case, it's both of them. And neither of them. The conversation has lulled in recent months because the two Silicon Valley residents took a step back from the discussion and away from the spotlight to focus on other projects, which almost definitely involve AI. That said, AI and its applications haven't slowed down in the slightest, and that's something to keep in mind. So, should we be preparing for a robot revolution, or is this an unnecessary concern which we should ignore and continue to enjoy the benefits of our automated assistants? While there are a plethora of moral implications surrounding AI, it is unlikely that an AI would have any self-awareness or bad intentions until we develop a general or superintelligence. Right now, AI has the mental capacity of a cockroach, so as it stands, it needs to have a specific purpose defined by its creator. Although, with this in mind, it's not a far-reaching thought that in the wrong hands, AI could potentially be world-ending. Nonetheless, AI itself, in its current technological state, bears no moral responsibility. That belongs to the human who designs and controls it. Scary, yes, but we're often not far from a human or group of humans making a questionable decision and causing harm. That said, what Musk is more concerned about is the long term, where we will be dealing with AGI and it will be out of humanity's control. We are somewhat clueless when it comes to how an AGI would think beyond the realms of the human mind, and therefore its behavior is unpredictable. So maybe Zuckerberg's almost naive optimism that AI is humanity's greatest hope seems to overlook certain aspects of the long term that we should be paying attention to. Nevertheless, he is probably correct in that, in the present, AI is enhancing our lives in ways we never thought possible. And you can understand how someone wouldn't want progress to be stifled by regulations. Consider, for example, that we now have AI that can detect and treat 50 different types of eye disease with 94% accuracy. AI can also translate voice conversations in at least 10 languages, redefining the idea of bringing the world together. So, who knows what it could do for us if we allow progress to continue without barriers? But what does all this tell us? It tells us that neither CEO should be ignored. Zuckerberg is right about the short term. AI is a game changer, and using it to our advantage can give us a standard of living only seen in utopian science fiction. However, Musk's concern about AI are more than justified. We're playing with fire, and if we don't put safety measures in place early, we may be looking at a Skynet-like reality sooner than we think.